everybody, Joey here again, and welcome back to the third video on how to build a large aquarium system. In last week's video, we built a pair of 200-gallon acrylic aquariums. In this video, we're going to build the stand for both of these tanks. This stand will actually be a rack that will allow me to stack these tanks one on top of the other. Now before we get started, I wanted to first let you know if you need specific details on how to build an aquarium stand or even a canopy for your aquarium, I actually already have a comprehensive 3-part video series on how to do it. I also have a playlist containing a few different designs for stands that you will also find useful, including other racks. Now due to this fact that this stand will not be any different than the design I have shown previously, we're not going to get into a step-by-step process because I don't really want to bring you repetitive content. So to get started with this stand, I first needed to decide on materials to use. Now based on the design and lack of center supports, I needed to ensure I used a strong enough lumber for this rack. So I went with 2x8 lumber for this build. Laying horizontal and on edge, an 8-foot piece of this lumber will support about 1,000 pounds before it starts to slightly bend. Now that's unsupported. With the design I'm using, this number almost doubles due to the supportive nature of the ends and additional diagonal supports. With that said, I will be using 2 of these for each tank. To summarize, each level will support more than double the intended use. The entire structure will be held up by 8 2x8s. Now a vertical 2x8 can easily support 1600 pounds itself. With the additional support and guides that this design offers, this number also increases. So using these numbers, the total stand will support a total load of almost 13,000 pounds. While each level can support an evenly distributed load of over 4,000 pounds. Now obviously this stand is much stronger than I need. So before we get into the dimensions of the stand and how it will work with the tanks, I'll first show you a quick time lapse of me building this rack. We'll be right back. the dimensions of this rack, obviously the length and width was determined by the tanks themselves. However, the height was determined by three factors: the filtration, the height of the room that this will go in, and how much working room I needed above each tank. I needed the tank's overflows to be a certain height and distance for the filter. So that determined the height of the bottom rack. The distance between the bottom rack and the top rack was determined by the room I needed to be able to get in between the tanks to work on them. I allowed myself a foot of working room above the bottom tank. The overall height was determined by the height of the ceiling and allowable room I would have with the top tank. I still have plenty of room to get into the top tank, but we'll need to use a stool to do so. All three of these needs were coordinated to come up with the dimensions of the stand. Now, as you will remember from the last video, these tanks were 96 inches long, 36 inches wide, and only 14 inches tall. So the total length of the stand is 115 inches long. This will allow the tanks to slide into place without any wood obstructing the front view. The rack is 37 inches wide, allowing the tanks a bit of room on the width. The rack stands 60 inches tall total. Now, since I'm using acrylic aquariums, I also needed to ensure I fully supported the bottom of them. So adding in diagonal supports topped with 3/4 inch plywood was a must, followed by 1/2 inch sheet of styrofoam to absorb any irregularities in the plywood. The total cost on this stand was actually just under $200, which included everything I have shown. Now I have to move the rack into its final place in another room and get these tanks onto it. But there is a wall and a 500 gallon aquarium standing in its way. So in next week's video, we will take the wall down and take the 540 gallon aquarium apart. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I also wanted to thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.